A potentiometer is an instrument designed to measure an unknown voltage by comparing it with a known voltage. The known voltage may be a standard cell or any other known voltage reference source. In all cases, the unknown PD, or the unknown voltage, is compared with the potential difference across the slide wire. Looking at this diagram, we are having a potentiometer circuit, having a driver cell with an EMF and an internal resistance. This driver cell is connected to a slide wire. This slide wire can be of any length. Now, the combination of this slide wire and the driver cell circuit, this top part, is what comprises or makes the primary circuit of the potentiometer circuit. Now, the secondary circuit is made up of a galvanometer and another cell. It could be a cell, it could be a resistor. So these are connected from point A up to J. So this downer part makes the secondary circuit. Now, in the secondary circuit, we are having a galvanometer with a sliding jockey J. So this jockey is slid along this wire, and the balance point is obtained when the galvanometer reading shows zero deflection. Just like the way we derived the balance condition for the Wheatstone bridge. The driver cell produces current. Current that it produces, we are calling it the primary current or the driver current. There are some guidelines that we follow whilst connecting this potentiometer. All higher potential terminals, point A is the point where the primary circuit and the secondary circuit are connected. We know that the positive terminal of a cell is the terminal that has got a higher potential, and the negative terminal has got a lower potential, and current will always flow from a point of higher potential towards the point of lower potential. So the two points that are having higher potentials should always be connected at the same end, and that is at point A. So all higher potential points of the primary and secondary circuits must be connected together at point A, and the lower potential points must be connected together at point J, and that is the point where the jockey meets with the slide wire. The other issue we need to know is that the value of the known potential difference, or the known PD, and in this case the known PD is always the PD that is across the driver cell, or the EMF of the driver cell, must be greater than the value of the unknown potential difference to be measured. Now, this cell X has got an EMF that we do not know. Right here we could have a cell, or we could have a resistor or something, as we shall see later. The potential difference here should be higher than the potential difference of whatever that is here that we do not know. Because now, if it so happens that the potential difference across the components in the secondary circuit are higher than the potential difference across the component, the driver cell, then it means that we won't be able to obtain a balance point. Then the other thing that we need to know is that the current in the primary circuit must remain constant, and the sliding jockey must not be slided in contact with the wire. So, because if you slide this jockey while it is in contact with the wire, you're most likely to scrape off part of this wire. Now, if you scrape it off, it means that you're going to make the cross-sectional area of this wire non-uniform, and when the cross-sectional area of the wire is not uniform, it will simply mean that the PD per unit length of that wire will be variable. And yet the diameter of the wire, by principle, must be uniform throughout for you to be able to obtain accurate results. So a potentiometer is used to get the unknown PD that is connected across it. The unknown potential difference that is always connected in the secondary circuit can either be a PD across a resistor, or it can be the terminal potential difference of a cell on an open or closed circuit, or it can be the EMF of a thermocouple, and so on and so on. The other advantage is with this potentiometer is that no current flows in the secondary circuit, and as a result, no power is consumed in that secondary circuit. By secondary circuit, I mean the circuit that contains the unknown EMF or the unknown PD that we are looking for. We should also know that this potentiometer is always used to measure voltage drops that are produced by the unknown current that is passing through a known standard resistance, since it measures voltage. This potentiometer is also used for the calibration of voltmeters and ammeters, and it is used as an industrial standard. So we are going to look at a few cases, just only two cases, where we analyze how we find this unknown PD. In this case one, we shall explore how we find the unknown potential difference of this cell X. Let's examine this potentiometer. If we want to find the EMF E here, let's say this is the EMF E of this cell in the secondary circuit. This cell here has an EMF E and an internal resistance, let's call it R. Now, the potential difference between A and J at balance condition here is going to be equal to the PD across this cell. And so this will be the EMF of that cell. Now, remember we first slide this jockey along this wire. We obtain a point along this point whereby no current is flowing through the galvanometer, and that is the balance point of that potentiometer. Now, at that point where there is no current flowing through, the potential difference across this point and J should be equal to the potential difference across that cell. At balance, the potential between A and J. Now at balance, when the galvanometer is not deflecting, the potential difference across A and J is being balanced against the potential difference of this cell in the secondary circuit. Now, this slide wire AB is having the primary current from the driver cell running through it. So it means that we need to first find the potential difference that is across A and B with respect to the driver cell. So when we get the potential difference that is across AB, then it means we can get the potential difference per unit length, which we shall call the PD per unit length of this entire slide wire, by getting the potential difference across it and we divide that by the total length. So after getting the PD per unit length, it means that once we obtain the balance position here, and we have the value of L, it means that we simply multiply the PD per unit length of the wire multiplied by the balance length for us to get the PD across a certain portion of the slide wire. So it means for us to get the PD across A and J, we get the potential difference per unit length and multiply that by the balance length L. So it means here VAJ is going to be PD per unit length times the balance length. But then at balance, at the same time, here, the potential difference between A and J is equivalent to the potential difference that is across this cell, and which in essence is the EMF of that cell. So it means likewise, this VAJ is the same as also the EMF of that cell, like we have shown, that VAJ is going to be the EMF of that cell. So it means that if we equate the two VAJs, then we know that the PD per unit length, multiply that by L, should be equal to the EMF of cell X, which cell is in the secondary circuit. Now, when we obtain our balance position and there is no current that is flowing through, it means there is no power being dissipated. We said that the potential difference across that portion of the slide wire between A and the balance point or the null position is equal to the potential difference that is across whatever components that are in the secondary circuit. Now, in this case, we have that at balance, the potential between A and J is going to be equal to the PD per unit length of this whole wire. Multiply that by the balance length for us to get that portion. But also, the potential across this is equal to the potential that is across the effective resistance of this combination. In our secondary circuit, we have a resistor and we have a cell with an internal resistance. So the potential difference that is across this effective resistance also is equal to the potential VAJ. So in this case, potential VAJ is going to be equal to also, VAJ is the terminal PD of cell X in a closed circuit, and which is also equal to the PD across the effective resistance of that. So meaning that for us to get the PD across the effective resistance, To get the PD across this effective resistance, V is going to be equal to the current that is going through this secondary circuit, and we know that the current through this secondary circuit is going to be current produced by that cell, I, times the resistor, the effective resistance, R. So meaning that VAJ is going to be giving us the current I times R. This is current in the secondary circuit. Our current is this going to be current in the secondary circuit multiplied by the effective resistance. Now here we are having a resistor R and an internal resistance up there. The effective resistance therefore will be equal to the product of those resistors, divide that by the sum. And that goes, now the current in the secondary circuit, multiply that by the internal resistance, is supposed to give us the EMF of that cell. So it's EMF times R over R plus R. That is VAJ. Therefore, the PD per unit length times L should be equal to this. We shall expound more on this in our next video as we make some illustrative examples. This brings us to the end of this video. Thank you for watching. Somebody out there needs to watch this video. Don't forget to like and share. For more videos, simply subscribe to Kisembo Academy. Otherwise, I'll catch you in the next video. For Kisembo Academy, this is Arnold Ranga Kuramya.